Hello everyone, I just uploaded a new video comparing LTX 0.95 and 0.96. Now LTX 0.97 is finally here, and this time it is a huge update. Let's dive into what is new and improved. Here are some sample videos. Generated by using 0.97 motor. It looks very nice. In previous versions, like 0.95 and 0.96, the main focus was on generating videos quickly. No matter how fast or well trained the motor was, the final video quality wasn't perfect, especially when it comes to human faces. This was largely due to the small training parameters. If you wanted to use those videos, you often needed special techniques to upscale them and fix the issues. Now, with version 0.97, the parameters have been massively upgraded from 2 billion to 13 billion. There is also a quantized 14B version available. This upgrade significantly improves the final video quality. Let's take a close look at how it performs. This model offers a test hub online, and the link is provided in the description below. You can try it for free by logging into the homepage using a Google email account. The homepage interface is user-friendly and looks like this. Simple click on Video 2 New. The 13B motor is already available, allowing you to control motion, camera angles, and character actions. Give it a try. Output videos are impressive. You can choose between their free plan or a paid plan. However, since this is an open source project, I personally prefer installing it locally. If you did not install this motor before, please watch my previous video. It has complete installation process. If you have already installed an old version, update is simple. Just start a config UI, select Update All. It will automatically update all the necessary packages. For the best experience, you will need a GPU with at least 14GB of VRAM. In my case, with only 8GB, the motor still works, but it uses system RAM to store data, which slows things down quite a bit. Since versions 0.95 and 0.96 are pretty similar, I will compare 0.95 directly with 0.97. In 0.95, you will often see defects in the output videos, especially in human faces. For example, the video qualities might look decent overall, but the girl's eyes or mouth might have noticeable issues. With 0.97, these defects are greatly reduced. In another test video featuring a robot woman, there wasn't much difference between versions. However, when testing a motor running on the street, the older versions struggled, producing blurred or broken outputs. 0.97 handled it much better. It is clear that the quality of the input image plays a bigger role in the final result. One of the most exciting updates in 0.97 is the new upscale feature, which is directly integrated into the latent space. This improves both the quality and the speed of upscaling. But here is the catch. All of this requires a high VRAM GPU, like an RTX 4090 with 24GB of VRAM. On my old RTX 2070 with just 8GB of VRAM, the upscale function doesn't work due to out-of-memory ohm errors. For example, when I generate a 97-frame video using my workflow, it took 2070 seconds, that is over 30 minutes for a 5-second video. Considering the large parameters of the motor, it is amazing that it can run at all. On a running hub with an RTX 4090, this process takes just 1 minute and 42 seconds. which is incredibly fast for a motor of this scale. Download a simple workflow from the homepage. The process involves two steps. Generate a low-resolution video. Upscale it to the final resolution. To achieve the best output video quality, it is crucial to start with a clear and high-quality image. A high-quality initial image ensures better results, as it will later be compressed to the final image size. For the checkpoint motor, select 17B0.97 DEV and ensure that the clip uses the same LTX motor system. Use D5XXL FB16 and select the LTXV type. In the base low resolution generation phase, the STG node may appear complex, but it is recommended to leave all settings at their default values. The STG node divides the image into smaller pieces that can be handled by the low-VRAM GPUs. For the STG advanced presets, if you aim to make the video dynamic, balanced, or upscaled, select the corresponding preset. Avoid selecting 2B. In the LTXV base sampler, input the desired final video size, ensuring it does not exceed 720x1280, and keep the number of the frames below 257. For reference, generating an 822x480 video with 97 frames on a RTX 27-day took over 30 minutes. Maintain the strength parameter between 0.75 and 0.9, and leave other parameters at their default settings. And other parts are upscale parts. Unfortunately, when I run this motor on the running hub using the sample workflow, I encounter OOM errors. The low resolution part works fine. The upscale part has issues. I have tried multiple times, but haven't figured out the issue yet. I will keep working on it and update you once I find a solution. For low VRAM users, if you are using the FP8 version on a low VRAM GPU, you will need a special workflow. This workflow includes an FP attention patch, but I received an error message. Q8 kernels are not available. Please install them to use this feature. The error also mentioned that my GPU isn't supported. Unfortunately, the rumors are true. GPUs like the RTX 2070 don't have FP8 processors. It is disappointing for an older GPU, but I'm grateful to the developers for giving us the chance to use the full motor, even if it is slow. Honestly, I don't mind the wait. Let the computer run while I grab a coffee and take a break. For text-to-video, as I experimented, 0.97 is still not as good as I expected. Conclusion: version 0.97 brought significantly improvements to video quality. On high VRAM GPUs, generation speed has improved considerably. However, on low VRAM GPUs, the speed has decreased significantly. Despite this, it remains functional. This balance of the improvements makes the update worthwhile overall. Unfortunately, the FP8 quantized version and the upscale functions did not work for me. In fact, it is written in the homepage. Quantized motor will come in soon. Hold it. I forgot to see this earlier. If you find this content helpful, please consider to subscribe to my channel. Your support means a lot. Thanks for watching.